Dear students, open the grades. I remain Mr. Mbak William from Unibec Group of School, Port Harcourt. Today we'll be doing a revision content from where we stop. The topic is pollution. As you can see, the subject is basic science. The term pollution, I believe, is not a strange word for some of us. Is a regular word we hear in our day-to-day activity. First of all, what's pollution? Pollution is, can I say, is the release of harmful substances to the environment. So pollution is the release of harmful substances to the environment. We can say it's the contamination of the environment. Now, when I say contamination, it means release of things that are not good for the body into the environment. We call it pollution. Now, let me just take it down so you see. Pollution is the release of harmful substances to the environment. And when I say release, I mean talking about we are contaminating the environment. Now there are certain substances, there are different substances that can pollute the environment. Now, let's not talk about pollutants. Pollutants are the substance that causes pollution. Let me take note of that. And pollutant could be in different form. Pollutant could be gaseous, could be solid, could even be liquid in nature. So now the next we'll talk about is types of pollution. Types of pollution. Before I continue, let me go back again. Pollutants. Pollutants are substances that pollute the environment, or that causes pollution, or that contaminates the environment. We call them pollutants. Types of pollution. Now, pollution could be in different types or different forms. We have the water pollution. We have the land pollution. We have air pollution. We also have noise pollution. Say, we have the water pollution. We have land pollution. We have air pollution.
Now, when someone pulls into
solid pollutant of the water. Polluting water bodies could also be in liquid form. For instance, oil spillage. Now, when you know, when crude oil spills, can pollute water, thereby killing the water habitat or the animals that live in water bodies, such as fishes, because they will not be taking enough oxygen, they will die. So, in polluting water, when water has been contaminated, we refer to it as water pollution. Or we can say it is the release of harmful substances into water bodies. And I give you an example of water pollutant. One is what? Oil spillage in water bodies. When oil spill in water bodies, it has polluted the water. Another example is release of excreta in water, urinating water bodies. These are harmful substances that can kill aquatic habitats. Now, another pollution we have is land pollution. Land pollution refers to as the release of harmful substances to the land. And when I say land, I mean where we are standing, this land, our land, where we cultivate our crop, where we stand, is land. So when harmful substances are released to this land, it could cause land pollution. Now, remember I said just now that crude oil spillage could cause water pollution. Crude oil spillage could also cause land pollution. Yes. Like, for example, let's take an instance. In Ogoni, we do here Ogoni cleanup. Sometimes some of this oil spillage, when it's oil spill, they even affect the land that crop can't even grow on the land, thereby polluting the land. It has spoiled the land. So land pollution could be in different form. So when harmful substances are released into land, it causes land pollution. Another is air pollution. Now please let's have it in mind. When land is polluted, at times it might even affect the growth of crop. Might affect cultivation of crop in that land sometimes. Please let's have it in mind. Another is air pollution. When we talk about air pollution, we refer to as release of harmful substances into the air. That's what we refer to as what? Air pollution. No, some of these multinational companies, some of these refineries, some of the gases they emit, sometimes may not be good for us. That affects the air we breathe sometimes. For example, a compound like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, okay. What we can call carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, CO. This gas causes air pollution. So you can see this gas causes. Now you can get it from exhaust fume. For example, when I say exhaust fume, an instance, you have seen large vehicle moving. There's one thing they bring from the exhaust, or call what some of us call locally called smoke, or locally called smoke, call it exhaust fume. That thing is not good for the body. That's the concept of carbon dioxide or carbon monoxide. It affects the air we breathe in. It affects the air we breathe in, thereby causing air pollution. Air pollution could also come as a result of release of things that have offensive smell. For instance, someone comes to the sitting room in your house and poo on the floor. You will not be able to stay there because you'll be experiencing all kinds of offensive odor. That offensive smell has polluted the air. Where you understand? So air pollution referred to as release of harmful substance into the air. Noise pollution.
Noise pollution. Now let's have it in mind that the human ears has this a certain level of sound our ear is supposed to hear, to listen to. There's an amount in which we are allowed to listen to. Some of us, we just, when we are playing music, we loud it. It's no longer music, it's now noise. It can affect one's ear. Hearing, even the eardrum can affect it. So, things that are not good, noise pollution can come as a result of what? Loud speakers. Loud sound that are not good for the ear. So, can get it like that. Let's talk about control of pollution. Now, how do we control pollution? Now, let me digress a bit. Sorry, let me go back a bit. Remember, talking about water pollution, release of harmful substances in the water, talk about land pollution, talk about air pollution, release of harmful substances in the air, talk about noise pollution. The next one we'll talk about is control of pollution. Control of pollution. How do we control pollution? And when I say pollution, I'm referring to pollution, either water pollution, land pollution, air pollution, or noise pollution. How do we control pollution? One way we can control pollution is cleaning of gutters. Now, in this case, I'm referring to any of these four. Cleaning of gutters. Cleaning of gutter. Now, cleaning of gutters in this case is representing land pollution. I'm trying to control land pollution in this case, or even water pollution. Cleaning of gutter is one way you can control pollution. Another way you can control pollution is burning of refuse in incinerator. Burning of refuse in incinerator. It's not good for us to just take refuse and dump it anyhow to avoid land pollution. Don't just take what the refuse, anything, just dump it anyhow. You burn it in incinerator. When I talk about incinerator, is properly prepared for burning of refuse to avoid pollution. So in this way, you can control pollution. Another control of pollution would be pesticides and fertilizers. Applied in correct amounts and manner. Now, see something. Pesticide and fertilizer should be applied in correct amounts and manner. Now, in this case, we are trying to prevent land pollution. We are trying to work prevent land pollution. Pesticide. What are pesticides? These are chemicals that are used to what? Kill pests. Herbicides. Fertilizers and fertilizers. They should be used in the correct amount or manner. That's one way you can prevent what? You can control pollution. You don't just go and spray pesticide anyhow. You don't just go to your land now and just take fertilizer and pour them anyhow. There's a way you put fertilizer, it might even cause harm to the crop growing or to the soil instead of you promoting the soil. So there's a need for you to take precaution. Another way you can control pollution is sewage should be properly treated before discharges. So, these are more ways we can control pollution. Now, also, we can also control pollution, especially noise pollution, by regulating the amount of sound we listen to. Let me even add it to it. Regulates the amount of sound by we listing to. You can also control, especially noise pollution, regulate the amount of sound you listen to, so that it doesn't affect you. So I believe so far we have gotten more plans so far. We started by pollution. So pollution is the release of harmful substances into the environment. I also said it is the contamination of the environment. Then I also talked about pollutants. I said pollutants are substances that contaminate the environment. Then I talked about types of pollution. I said pollution could be in different types. Talked about soil pollution, that's land pollution, water pollution, air pollution, noise pollution. Then we describe each of them. Then I'm talking about control of pollution. Now, in our next class, we will continue from this topic, talk about effect of pollution and others. But for now, we stop here. Before we stop here, I'm going to give an assignment for you to do on your own and practice and show if you've really understood what you've learned so far. Our assignment for today will be: Make sure you do it. Our assignment for today, for you to state 5 ways. Water pollution. State 5 effects. Water pollution. See you in our next class. God bless you.